Good day, students. Welcome to math.serve.com. In this clip, we're going to be going over how to solve multi-step equations. Let's write down the instructions for the problems. We are to solve each equation. Okay? For problem number one, we have the equation 15 plus 6x is equal to x minus 7 minus 8. Now, before ever solving an equation, it's beneficial to examine what type of equation you have so you can know what your possible answers are going to be. Now, this is an algebraic equation with variables on both sides. Now, whenever you have an equation with variables on both sides, you do not always have a solution. Okay? You can have one unique solution, you can have infinitely many solutions, or you can have no solutions at all. Okay? Let me give you an example of how your answers will look like in the three cases. Okay, so for case one, if you have one solution, your answer is going to look something like this. You have x equals a number like x equals 2. You can also have infinitely many solutions, so infinitely many solutions. If you have infinitely many solutions, your answer is going to look like this, 4 equals 4. You will end up with an identity, a true statement, with no variables of any sort present in your final step. And then lastly, when solving equations with variables on both sides, you can have no solutions. No solutions. An example of a situation where you have no solutions is 3 equals 5. What do you notice about this? This is a false statement. So when you solve an algebraic equation and you end up with a false statement, then you know that there are no solutions. Okay, so you have to keep this in mind anytime you're solving algebraic equations with variables on both sides, such as this. Okay, now let's go ahead and solve this equation and see if we will have one solution, no solutions, or infinitely many solutions. Now, the first thing we want to do is we want to collect all the variables on one side and all the constants on the other side. Now, any variable that does not have a coefficient, we're going to give it the default coefficient of 1. Like in this case, this variable does not have a coefficient, so we'll put a 1 in front of it. Okay? Now, let's collect all the x's to the left and have all the numbers to the right. Before we do that, you notice that I can simplify this right side a little bit first, so let's rewrite this. 15 plus 6x equals 1x minus 7 minus 8. The signs are the same, so we add and keep the sign, negative 15. Now let's collect all the x's on the left and the constants on the right. This is positive 1, so we are going to subtract 1x from both sides of the equation. Okay, by subtracting 1x, this adds up to 0. Now, this is positive 15. What I'm going to do is I'm going to add 15 to both sides of my equation. Actually, I'm going to subtract. So, subtract 15, because this is positive 15, so we'll subtract 15 from both sides of the equation. Now let's see what happens here. The goal is we want variables on the left and constants on the right. Now you notice these two are opposite, so they add up to 0. Positive 6 minus 1x is 5x, positive 5x. On the right side, these two are opposites, they add up to 0. And now negative 15 minus 15, the signs are the same, so we add and keep the sign, 30. Now what do you notice? We have collected all the x's to one side and we've combined them in the process. And we have all the numbers combined on the other side of the equation. Now to finish this off, we'll simply divide both sides by 5 to isolate x. And then we'll have x equals negative 6. Okay? So which of these types of solutions does this result fit? It fits option 1. We have one unique solution. Now let's do a quick check just to make sure that our answer is in fact correct. So let's do a check. Now how do we check our work? We'll simply plug our result into the original equation and see if we end up with a true statement. Okay? So we have 15 plus 6 instead of x, I'll put in my solution there, equals x minus 7. So instead of x, we'll put negative 6 minus 7 minus 8. Now if this turns out to be a true statement, then our result is in fact correct. Okay, so we have 15. Positive 6 times negative 6 is negative 36 equals, now negative 6, we can combine negative 7 minus 8, which is negative 15. 15 minus 36, if we combine these two, we will get negative 21. And then if we combine these two, we have negative 21. So it's negative 21 equals negative 21. The answer is yes. So we're confident that our answer is in fact correct. Okay? All right. Now let's box our final answer and move on to question number 2. Okay, number 2, we have another multi-step equation. 4 times y plus 7 plus 4 times y minus 1 equals 8y minus 8y. Okay, what do you notice about this equation? It has variables on both sides. So since this equation has variables on both sides, there could either be one solution, infinitely many solutions, or no solutions at all. Okay, so let's expect any of those cases to apply as we discussed in question number 1. So how do we solve this? Well, we have to simplify both sides of our equation first. On the left side, we have to follow the order of operations. Please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. Look in the parentheses. Can we simplify the quantities in the parentheses? The answer is no. So the next thing we have to do is multiply, okay? So we'll distribute 4 to y and 7, and then distribute 4 to y and negative 1. So that yields 4y plus 28 plus 4y minus 4. On the right side, these two are like terms because they have the same degree and similar variables. If we combine them, signs are different. We're going to subtract. We end up with 0. Now we've simplified the right side completely. We can still do some work on the left side. 4y and 4y are like terms, the same degree, the same variable. Combine these two, we'll have add the coefficients 8y. Now 28 and negative 4 are like terms, they're both constants. Since the signs are different, subtract and keep the sign of the bigger one, we have positive 24 equals 0. Now we want to isolate y, so that we have to move the constants to the other side of the equation. So we subtract 24 from both sides. That yields 8y equals negative 24. Now to finish off this equation, we'll simply divide both sides by 8. And we'll have y equals negative 3. Now is our answer correct? We have to do a check to verify the accuracy of our result. So let's go ahead and do the check. To do a check, we'll simply take our answer and plug it into the original problem. So we'll have 4 times negative 3 plus 7 plus 4 times negative 3 minus 1 equals 8 times negative 3 minus 8 times negative 3. On the left side, we're going to follow the order of operations, as simplify the quantities in the parentheses first. Remember, please, excuse my dear Aunt Sally, you do the parentheses first, okay? So we have 4 times minus 3 plus 7, subtract and keep the sign of the bigger one, plus 4 times minus 3 minus 1, same signs, you add and keep the sign the same, negative 4. On the right side, still following the order of operations, we'll simply multiply first before we subtract. So we have negative 24 minus 8 times minus 3 minus times minuses plus. When you multiply numbers with the same sign, you always have a plus. 8 times 3 is 24. On the left side, following the order of operations, now we multiply before we add or subtract. 4 times 4 is 16. Positive 4 times negative 4. Since the signs are different, when you multiply numbers with different signs, you end up with a negative always. 4 times 4 is 16. On the right side, minus 24 plus 24 is 0. 16 minus 16 on the left side is 0. Is 0 equals 0? The answer is yes. So we are confident that our initial answer is in fact correct. Okay? So that's that. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other tutorials such as this. More clips can be found on math.serve.com. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.